I hope you let the kids stay up tonight to see the amazing story of Atlanta's most adorable million-selling pop group. They're called ABC, another bad creation. And kids and adults alike are captured by their simple playground-inspired tunes and their pumping, high-energy performance. The well-mannered, gentlemanly tykes look like they could be the boys next door. And they were, in fact, the kids next door to each other in a College Park neighborhood. They were discovered by a daring dreamer while they danced on a street corner to get quarters for candy.
I swing my beat at the playground, you know.
You won't find them on the street corner anymore, singing for soda and chips. No, now the seasoned performers are more likely to be center stage at the Apollo, hanging out with Arsenio. But we did coax them into a free sidewalk rap outside their classroom at the private Riverside Learning Lab in Sandy Springs.
JoJo, he's the youngest. Girls jock me because I'm best dressed. Girl, I'll run in the neighborhood.
P.S. On say, don't say.
When they are not on the road, the six are tutored by three teachers dedicated just to them. Their specialized curriculum includes Spanish, taught with a competitive flashcard game.
Hermana, brother, sister. That's right.
Other elementary school classes may study Japan and geography, but these kids have been there.
You all just went on a long trip to a country. Tell me where it was.
Japan.
That's right.
A tutor travels with them when they are performing on the road. It's a glamorous life for these kids born in the College Park projects, but they miss a lot of what their other friends are experiencing at this age.
What about girls? Who's got a girlfriend?
None of us.
Why not?
Too busy and too young.
Just how young are they?
All I'm G to the A, 13.
I'm RoRo, I'm 13.
I'm Chris, I just turned 13.
I'm Red and I'm 12. Mark and I'm 9.
Little Dave's in the house and I'm 8. I'm 9.
Little David, the epitome of cute, and his friend, Chris, used to hang out in front of a College Park beauty salon, street dancing. That's when they were discovered by Kevin Wales, a full-time airline employee, part-time performer, whose sister worked at the salon.
They used to always tell me about these little guys. These little boys are just so cute, you should see them.
Kevin, who was barely out of pubescence himself, came and saw and believed enough in them to give up his 9-to-5 job to manage Dave and Chris and their four other neighborhood friends.
They danced for me and everything, and right then it was like the answer to my dreams about being in the music industry, anything. It was just there. It was like, stop everything you're doing and just get into this. You know?
He choreographed routines for them and started booking performances at Atlanta shopping malls and talent shows. Now, when Kevin said, I'm going to make you a star, were you all kind of going like, come on, man?
It's like we really trusted him.
Yeah.
So we did talent shows and swept Atlanta, you know, just swept it. You know.
How did you convince the parents? Because parents would be skeptical, but when you say, I'm going to take your babies off to California and everywhere else and make them stars.
Oh, yeah. Well, believe me, it was kind of tough at first, but after they got to know me and see what I was doing with the kids as far as the talent shows and things around Atlanta, and the success just spoke for itself. You know, just
word got around about the group, and they were flown to Los Angeles to audition for Michael Bivins, a former New Edition singer and now member of Belle Biv DeVoe. 21-year-old Bivins loved them and took them to Motown, where they were signed with a legendary label. Their first album, Coolin' at the Playground, hit the Billboard Top 20 chart this summer, and their single, Iesha, went to the top 10. While their peers are out cooling at the playground, ABC is in an Atlanta warehouse that's been converted to rehearsal space. Every day from 3 to 6:30 or later, manager and choreographer Wales puts them through a disciplined, rigorous routine, shaping up a show they can take on the road in the spring. It's a workout that would make the ever-dry Jane Fonda break a sweat. I mean, what have you guys really given up to have your dream of being stars?
Everything, really.
Yeah,
the only thing I do is ride my dirt bike and go to school and practice. That's it. That's all we really need to do. And plus, it's a lot of like bad things and stuff going around now. So I would say this is the best thing for us.
Yep.
What happened to the smile? Y'all mad at something? kids nowadays tend to go down the wrong road. It's either a right road or a wrong road. And a lot of times, even now, the wrong road looks better because, I mean, they see the fast money and the guys in around the neighborhood driving the big fancy cars, and they probably are not doing the right thing, but it's good that, you know, we have a few people that will come around and steer them down the right road. It's real hard.
With the royalty checks now in from their first platinum-selling album, the boys are starting to see the benefits of their hard work. A portion of their money will go into a trust fund for them.
You have to wait until how old?
18.
It's kind of happy because we want to know what to do with it anyway. Yeah.
Their parents have already received a percentage of the profits, and as a result, the group is expecting a Christmas sure to send Santa into pre-holiday depression.
I want, a color TV,
a dirt bike, clothes, a computer,
a motorcycle,
a bedroom set,
another dog,
a new house,
go-kart truck,
musical equipment, which be in a new apartment,
more toys,
motorcycle,
clothes,
that's all.
What happens when these young men's voices change and they get taller?
Well, we'll change the music, we'll change their image, we'll change their whole look, and we'll let them grow with their fans. That's what we want them to do. We don't want them to just stay on one level anyway.
If tomorrow it all goes away, could you go back to being just kids?
No. I don't never think we can go back to being just kids.
We don't. Last but not least, I want to say peace and we out of here from the playground. You know, from the playground, you know?
Peace.
ABC will perform at a Christmas party for young people ages 9 to 19 at Buckhead's Club Hollywood on December 25th. The cover charge is $7, and the party starts at 6. As always, I appreciate you joining us tonight. All of us at Close Ups hope you have the happiest of times this holiday season and a most prosperous and joyous new year. Good night.